Sega. Okay, something the heck, why up there? Okay, there we go. Yeah, apparently for some reason the VC face and the microphone were muted with that. And we didn't, I didn't mean to go back into there. So yeah, hello anyone who may be watching now or later, and welcome to Hillyan's Hub with me, Hillyan, along with
the fearsome Swede Drakir.
And welcome back to Showcase Sunday, number 55 actually, where we'll be showing off, where we'll be showing off up to four games for about half an hour each to see if they're any good for streaming later. And yeah, as is more than obvious, we're starting off with Valkyria Chronicles, a game that I've heard plenty about, and supposedly that it is really good as well, but I've never actually seen much gameplay of.
It is good, I can say that, since I have played this game myself. I not finished it, but it is nice, and how to say, it is unique in its own way. While it's while you play UVC, this part of history is obviously take inspiration of, but it do add a lot of its own flair to it to make it different as well.
Yeah, to my knowledge, it could be described as a sort of Fire Emblem set in the Second World War, but let's stop speculating and start looking into what's actually going on the Galian front. Okay, Irene Collar.
The year was 1935 EC. Two powers controlled the continent. In the east, the sun rose over the autocratic East European Imperial Alliance, otherwise known as the Empire. In the west, a network of loosely allied democracies formed the Atlantic Federation. Both powers depended on a precious mineral, ragnite, for their survival, and its growing scarcity led to the inevitable war. Hostilities began in the east when the Empire aggressively crossed their western border. The Atlantic Federation responded, and the Second European War was on.
EW2.
The Empire, with its vast military superiority, struck hard, gaining ground in early victories and putting the Federation on the defensive. Emboldened by their progress and momentum, the Empire set their sights beyond the borders of the Federation. In neighboring Gallia, a peaceful principality along the sea, they found their next victim. Gallia had long maintained its neutrality in the tensions between the two superpowers. But the rich stores of ragnite under the Gallian soil proved too tempting for the Empire. It amassed troops along the eastern border and invaded with all the force of an avalanche. Prologue. Gallia to arms.
Yeah. The comparison is more than obvious, even if they shovel things around a bit.
Yeah, even on the map, it resembles Europe, but it's a bit different. Though I just realized now after watching this intro that it's awkwardly similar to something that's happening now.
Let's see. Well, windmills, we can never guess what those might be hinting towards.
Outside the Gallian border town of Brule. Residents are leaving the town before the invasion, headed inland towards the capital.
I haven't been down this road in years. It really hasn't changed very much. Whoa! Already? Hey there, guys! You're beautiful. Starting early this year. You're heading upstream, huh? How's the water?
Um...
Yeah, I'm with those two. They're probably thinking, the hell is up with this guy?
Okay, bit of a zoologist.
I think so.
Freeze! Put your hands in the air. Slowly. Haven't seen you around before. What's your name?
My name's Welkin. And you are...
The one with the gun. We're with the Brueltown Watch. I'm Alicia. Alicia Melchiot. So, I'm wondering what you've been writing in that little book you've got there. Imperial spies are in the area.
This book is nothing, really. I was just sketching the fish and, you know...
Yes. Oh, I know. And you know there's a war on, don't you? All right then, Mr. Artist. We'll talk about fish sketching down at the station. Take him away.
Well, she suddenly finds him fishy.
Thanks, fish.
He heard you.
Yeah.
And also, why am I getting Dutch vibe from this area?
The windmills and such.
And the names. I have one small critique about this army's uniform.
And
that's
is?
The helmets. The helmets. They don't look like soldiers. They look like the fire brigade. Yeah, firemen. Like, I think I actually mistook them for firemen first. I thought, wait, why is the fireman wearing guns? Wheeling, I mean.
Flowers, bugs, and fish. You're not bad with a pen, are you? I have to say, they're really very good.
Thank you. So you see, I really was just sketching.
Maybe. Or this could be some kind of secret code. And I intend to take my time finding out for sure.
Great.
So now he's fishy Rex, and sketchy.
Is that you?
Isara. Oh, your timing is perfect.
What have you gotten yourself into now, Welkin? Wait. Don't you live at the old general's house?
That's right. I'm General Gunther's daughter, Isara.
You do know everyone's supposed to evacuate, right?
Yes. I'm aware of that. My brother's here to help me move to the capital, but that may be difficult. I mean, unless you're willing to let him go, that is.
Huh?
That pout.
I apologize, but I was just doing my job, you know. I saw you with the notebook and thought you were a spy. Again, I'm really sorry about that.
Thanks. Don't worry about it. I can see how I might have looked a little suspicious.
Welks has a real passion for observing nature. That's why he's studying it at the university, right?
Guilty as charged. I get so into it sometimes I forget where I am or that somebody might be watching me.
Gunfire! Everyone, keep your heads down!
Oh, over there. Really? Totally a way to show the people that you are the good guys, huh? Attacking civilians.
Welkin, you can handle a gun, right?
Yeah. I mean, I made it through training anyway.
Well, they're probably just a small scouting team. We should be able to take them out.
I'm with you.
Okay, here we go then.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Oh, open menu by pressing F and select save. Okay. Can we save? Yeah, we can save now. Let's create new. Or did that save? Yes, it did. Okay, just always good to double check.
Okay, here's the plan.
Okay, got the limited Imperial Scouts. They're approaching Brule. We'll deploy from here and take out all three of them.
So far, I have to say, everything seemed to be more of a mixture of a lot of European stuff. Like, the windmills and such, of course, invokes the Netherlands, or Holland, as some call it. But the names at the moment here are more German.
Yeah, I think they mixed it all in. Like, I just saw the map, I realized Scandinavia is missing.
Yeah, it is basically just Europe thrown through a blender.
Yeah, like, this is all right when done right.
Yeah, of course, the middle part of the Atlantic Federation very much resembles Germany, with to the left of it a bit that somewhat resembles France and Spain. But beyond that, it is just mangled, is would be one way to put it bluntly.
Yeah, like, I think one of the newer games actually made me very confused. For one of the country areas, it's named after the Danish area. But this is where the Turk is supposed to be.
That's three too many. Stay sharp.
So yeah, I got very confused.
There's something I should explain.
Command points. Combat starts, you'll see a map of the area and your unit's positions. This is referred to as command mode. Here you'll select the unit you'd like to move based on their position respective to the enemy, then press space. Doing so, use one of your command points displayed at the top of the screen. They reflect your ability as a commander and represent the number of times you can give instructions, i.e. control your units per each player phase. Okay, so that's how many actions we can have characters do. We'll have three CP. So there's three orders. Okay, let's try moving. Okay, let's move this around. Welkin. Okay, oh, zooms in. Action points. Use CP to select the unit in command mode and you'll be plunged into action mode. Here you can freely move units you selected around the field. As you move around in action mode, the action point gauge at the bottom of the screen will gradually deplete. Okay, I had a feeling something like this would happen, like similar to XCOM or Silent Storm. This represents that unit's mobility. Once it reaches zero, the unit will be unable to move any farther. Keeping on the unit's remaining AP while they're in motion is critical to keeping them safe. Okay. Dearly SD to move near the sandbags. Okay, quite a bit of mobility for this. Attacking. E to enter target modes. Use the Q and E to snap between targets. Minis will not attack while you're in target mode, so take your time to aim well before pressing fire. Shots will land somewhere within these circles surrounding the crosshair, so it's best to center it on the entire target. The only other game I really know that used something similar to this was Phoenix Point recently. Shots to the head or other weak points will result in greater damage. Unit can only attack from target mode up to once per action, so choose wisely before you open fire. If the target survives your attack, they may then launch a counterattack. Damage unit may not have the HP to survive the enemy's counter, so be careful when planning your attack. Basically, what we want to do now is do that. Okay, they've taken them out. If we hadn't taken them out, we could... Well, we're probably still going to take cover behind the sandbags.
Yeah, in this game, sandbags and infinite cover is your friend.
Okay. To return you to command mode, where you'll be able to select the next unit which can press escape and end the unit's action even if they have not attacked and still have AP. Okay, so we can end prematurely. Let's see, I'm not seeing the others, so let's crouch and end this action. Okay, I'm guessing that also means that the game automatically reloads. And let's move over to Alicia. Now, where are the other targets? Over there. Okay, so let's move up. Over there. Let's cross the bridge. Oop, about using cover. Standing near the sandbags, the command crouch will appear. Press space to the cover behind them. While hiding behind cover, units are harder to target, take less damage, and are immune to headshots and critical damage. Okay, that is a nice one.
So even if you can aim over cover, it is even if the enemy can still aim over the cover, it still helps you a lot than standing out in the open. Meanwhile, units caught out in the open by enemy attacks that will be easier to hit and could take significantly more damage. Advance carefully, moving from cover to cover, and always try to end your actions safely hidden from harm. Doing so should keep your troops alive long enough to secure a victory for Galia. And of course, Galia is a more Germanic name for France. Can we still reach this? Okay, I did not expect them to actually counterattack like that.
I've forgotten about that.
Okay, crouch. Okay. And then, can we actually command someone twice? Yes, we can, it seems.
Oh yeah, okay. We can, yeah. Oh yeah, he's doing suppressing fire.
Okay, take him down. Just flops down like that. And then we move over here.
Yeah, they have some mild ragdolling, but they made sure it's not completely insane.
And action, and end our turn. One player, enemy face, pair constitute a single turn. The fewer turns you complete a mission in, the more cash and experience. Sorry, it feels like some dust or something in my throat. The more cash and experience you'll receive at the end, but being too hasty can lead to unnecessary risks. It is to find a challenging balance. Okay, so it pays to be fast, but don't be reckless with it.
Indeed.
Now it's the Empire's turn. They also get three actions. Oh, hello.
Mm.
Okay.
That actually made me touch a side a little bit.
And it seems that they don't. The enemy can't double tap on a single unit, it seems. Using CP effectively when used well, even a limited pool of CP can take out a significant number of foes. CP can be used on the same unit multiple times, we already figured that out. For instance, a pool of 3 CP can be used to move one unit 20 times in a row, perfect for cutting into enemy lines or hurrying past dangerous terrain. That said, people get tired. They'll start each consecutive action with fewer AP than the last, so keep that in mind. Okay, good way to balance it. If you use the cancel button to end your phase with CP still remaining, the remaining those CP will be carried over to the next turn. Okay. CP are a precious resource. How you choose to manage them will define your fate. Alright. So it does pay to stockpile them a bit. So, yeah, let's go back to Alicia. And he's going to keep firing. So let's just move along the sandbags a bit, wait for him to stop shooting while he's reloads. We move over. Actually, we can move completely over, take a few more hits, and there we go. And there we go, first mission complete. Okay, 2 turns for a B rank, 200 experience and 500 cash, I'll just say. DCT Ducats. Okay, new episode, A Hilltop Promise. And even though she asked for his help, she'd ended up doing most of it after all.
Miss Melchior, there's no other sign of the enemy.
Good. Now, go keep watch and stay alert.
Yes, ma'am. What should we do with the bodies, ma'am?
We'll bury them. So it's begun. I'll do whatever it takes to protect the people of this town. I'll do it. Even going to war, I'll do it.
Dandelion seeds? Yeah.
What are those?
Seeds from the lion's paw. It blooms white, small, simple, and strong.
I want to be able to remember, once the war is over, that it wasn't all just people killing people. That even in war, there was also new life.
On the 15th day of the third month of the year 1935, the Empire began its assault in earnest. A formal declaration of war was made upon Gallia. Though it was only a small front in a massive continental assault, what followed would prove that a tiny nation could best a military giant.
Spoiler.
These events would tell a story of tragedy hidden in the mists of time. A story of courage and of trust, of persecution and hate, and of love blooming even through the flames of war. What follows is a record of this conflict and of those who fought, lived, and died.
Oh yeah, I think I remember some facts about this. Like, I remember there's supposed to be a third species in this world, but they decided against it before releasing it long ago.
Chapter 1. In
okay. And they were supposed to be the oppressed people, the beast folk, and the herd in black was supposed to be one of them.
Okay, let's have a look at this one. Okay, extendo windmill. Yeah, you won't see no one thing as long. You won't see one like that in Netherlands.
I hear that. It really is one of the most beautiful things about this town.
Why is it be like that?
It's a double-decker windmill.
Well, citizens, our enemy can't be far behind. I thank you for your help. Goodbye, and take care.
Okay, the lion's paw is the loading symbol. Along,
almost done. I only need to take the everyday basics.
Well, the Empire's got to be close by. Let's hit the road by sundown.
Martha, look! Wilkes is here!
Pardon?
Welcome back, Welkies!
You're still calling me that? Martha, I'm 22 years old. And more important, you shouldn't be running around. Aren't you due any day now?
A light jog won't hurt the little spud. I should know. I've already had 4 of them.
Okay.
Hello there. Is Welkin in?
Yep.
Oh, hello, Alicia. What brings you here?
A bribe of bread?
I just wanted to apologize. For before. Here. This is for you.
Really? These are for me?
I work at the bakery. Well, I did until the war started anyway. It's where I live, too.
Okay.
That's preserved bread, so it's pretty hard. Heat it up before you eat it, all right? I baked it myself, so the flavor's guaranteed. Best you ever had.
Better check it for gunpowder then, maybe.
Thanks. Do you want to come in?
Yeah, since he's been firing guns, so that there would be gunpowder on our hands, which could easily get into the mixture.
Shot at? You've had a busy day of it, haven't you, Welkies? And what a lovely lady you are for all that adventuring. Good job, Welkies.
What? Wait, no, it's not like that. Alicia just saved my skin, that's all.
Accurate.
He's right, we just met. I'm not his girlfriend, just his hero. Although I'm really hoping to be his friend.
Oh, well, I'm sure you will. Be good to my Welkies here, won't you?
Okay, seriously, Martha, enough with the Welkies already.
That's a lovely portrait. Is that General Gunther?
Oh, hello.
Yep. He was taken before I was born. But that's Dad.
Wait, what?
That's Dad? You're a lucky guy. And who's that with him there?
My father, Tamer. He was an engineer. The General's tank was his creation.
Okay.
Wait a minute. But I thought the General was your dad.
My birth parents died when I was a baby.
Ah.
The General was kind enough to take me in as his own after that.
Yeah. We're not related by blood, but she's definitely my little sister.
Yeah.
Sorry, was that question too personal?
No, I don't mind at all. I was blessed with two wonderful fathers.
Yeah. Guess you were, huh? Oh, is that really the time? I've got to get going.
Why don't you see her off, Welks? I can take care of the rest of this on my own.
All right, I will. I'll be right back.
See you later, Isara. Safe travels.
Okay, what the hell is this? I was shaking this stupid cough, so why is it coming back now?
Sometimes it... Yeah, sometimes you just have a random cough for no reason. I had that some week ago. I just laid in bed after eating breakfast, and I suddenly started coughing like mad. And I got close to today, but just that moment, I got very confused. I hope it don't tell me I'm getting cold. Don't tell me I'm getting cold. Ugh.
Okay, let's take a look here, and that'll probably be all the time we'll really have for this one.
Wow, look at this. Brule's really becoming a ghost town.
They've been leaving for a while. Just about everyone is evacuated by now. You can't blame them. Tensions are rising with the Empire.
We'll survive. The town watch will guard and protect the home front. Everyone will come back someday. They'll come back when it's safe again.
So, Welkin, I'm curious. Are you gonna join the army like your father?
I don't think that's for me. What I'd really like to do is be a teacher.
Huh. A teacher?
Yeah. Animals and insects, flowers and plants, they've always been my passion. I've learned a lot from nature. You see, my dad, he protected this country as a general, but it's just that I want to give back in my own way. My own way, you know what I mean?
I think I do. You're sure about it?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's deep, in your own way.
Okay, no more time for thinking. Time for killing.
That sound.
Ah!
Of course, go for the landmark first, huh? I've come again with this. You know, if you're going to kill off all the population, you're not going to have people to actually, you know, keep the town running.
Yeah, here's the thing. The mill. The Imperials are basically a mix of Soviet and, yeah, the Nazi.
Yeah.
And a bit spoiler, the her girl with the black hair, she's for the people group they eat. Imperials really dislike.
Get all the town watch together now. We've got to fend them off.
They must be at Mill Plaza. I'll help.
Thanks, Welkin. Now move out. Stay low.
Okay. We won't be able to get to this because we only have literally 10 seconds left on the timer for this one. So, yeah, I can see why people like this game. It is still, of course, very early on into it, but I'm assuming, of course... Yeah, it has a very Fire Emblem-ish feel to it. So, let's put down a save.
Yeah, but it's still its own beast, so to say.
Yeah.
But it's still its own thing, and it puts it off quite well.
And the combat system is interesting. I wouldn't be against streaming this eventually. We'll just have to see how long it might take up. Yeah, how long it might take at some points. If this would be better for, more edited playthroughs on YouTube instead of full on streaming.
Actually, considering I played this before, I can say stream this easy. However, the way it's built allows you to easily grind levels and such without continuing the story.
All right.
So
if we run into a roadblock, we could just grind some stuff off screen and then continue with the story after.
Yeah, for I'm not finished the game yet, still. So I cannot tell you how long, but since I'm a bit of a grinder just to make myself have easier time going through a story. So I still can recommend this.
Okay, so we can put this one on the list.
Yeah,
it is getting a very, very long list.
Yeah, a little bit warning. I think you may notice it is very visual.
And chatty.
Yeah, it's not too chatty, luckily enough.
Sega.
Not too much, but it has a lot of scenes. But it's placed up in smaller chunks, so I can take a easy pause and breathe at least.
Okay, next game. And yeah, going from one pretty well-known game to another. And give me a moment to move the screen up so it looks a bit better on my end. This is Vanquish. You probably heard of Platinum Games.
I didn't think Platinum Games were like a company. And I think I heard people mention Vanquish, but I had seen nothing of it. And for some reason, I thought Vanquish was fantasy game, fighting demons or something, but this is not what I expected.
Yeah. I think Platinum Games were in the news again recently. I've heard of a game that's flopped pretty hard. Babylon's Fall, but I don't remember if that was made by Platinum or not.
Yeah, the only reason I know Platinum is what they use re-release games for. I think I have the Borderscape Platinum Edition.
Okay.
But that's why I thought Platinum was a addition thing.
Oh, hello there. Starting the timer. Hello, Proto Raiden.
Sam, how's the view on your monitor?
Looking good. The
Scenery's a little bland, though.
All right. Let's proceed with functionality testing. We're starting with electro-optical targeting systems calibration.
Sam, I'm going to display a virtual target. Try to follow it visually.
Yeah, this totally feels like Frodo Revengeance. Okay.
If we still need to play at some point.
Yep. Let's see. You can change your camera control settings by selecting options in the pause menu. No need to.
This is a real pain in the ass. How many times you guys gonna make me do this?
It's important we have baselines, Gideon. Just because you can read a manual doesn't mean you know what you're doing.
Let's see.
He's right. Focus,
escape. Okay. Confirming to change your control type by selecting options. Yes.
True. You know I know what I'm doing, so let's do something different. What's on today's test schedule?
Look, I know you're in a rush to get to the bar, but we've got a lot to go over. Passing full control to you now.
Okay. Camera, basic movements.
You know, this is a real pain.
Already did that.
How many times you guys gonna make me do this?
It's important we have baselines, Gideon.
No button to really skip this, it seems.
You're doing.
Okay. I'm pressing tab, but it's actually not doing anything, so that tutorial is wrong on that, actually.
True. You know I know what I'm doing, so let's do something different. What's on today's test schedule?
Look, I know you're in a rush to get to the bar, but we've got a lot to go over. Passing full control to you now.
All right. Movements. Oh, hello.
Go ahead and give us some basic rotational movement readings.
Okay. There's basic third person controls. And okay, you can. You can stick to.
We're going to get readings on boost limitation. Engage whenever you want.
Boosts. Oh. Okay. Just slide around like on a freaking slip and slide. Try again. Proceed to the next checkpoint before the icon on the radar disappears. Okay. There.
Practical output on our current reactor design.
The suit's cooling system can't keep up with that output level. It's causing some temporary performance loss, especially in the skeletal actuators. I'm losing like 30% mobility here.
30% is within our project goals.
Elena, let's move on before Frank reads us the project grant, chapter and verse.
Okay, so the reactor on the back shows, how much, how long before you overcharge, I'm presuming?
Firing systems. Proceed with test.
Affirmative. Launching virtual target.
Wait, what kind of reactor?
Yeah, one on the back.
Yeah, I mean,
presumably not nuclear.
We're going to adjust the position. I pray it's not nuclear.
Okay, typical for the genre. Inaccurate hip fire, more accurate aimed fire.
But what other games has Platinum made?
I believe a Transformers game.
And functioning normally.
You can't suppress the recoil anymore?
Sam, your weapon isn't exactly stock.
I know.
Bayonetta games, I think?
Let's try firing something different.
Okay.
That is good.
Oh, that is a very stock sound. Okay. Assault rifle, SMG, and shotgun.
We're still working on expanding the number of configurations stored in memory. You can't just scan whatever you want and have it work. That being said, go ahead and activate the scanner.
Scanner. Disc launcher. Changing weapon will replace the currently equipped weapon, picking up the same type of weapon will replenish your ammunition. Okay.
I have not seen a disc launcher since Unreal Tournament.
Meat tribes, yeah, the tribes games. Okay, let's swap out this for the rocket launcher. Oh, upgrades. Okay, acquiring an upgrade item will upgrade the current weapon via the blade system and increase its effectiveness in various ways. Picking up the same weapon when already carrying the maximum amount of ammunition will allow you to proceed on the upgrade path of that weapon. Wait, does it mean that if you pick up the same one full, it gives an upgrade instead?
Blade can only replicate what already exists, even the imperfections.
Now we're going to check the grenade mounts.
Okay. No more grenades. This is effective against large groups of enemies or enemies hiding behind the cover. And that's... Oh, that's an impact grenade, or EMP grenades. Alright. Yep, and control lost. Okay, liking this so far. A bit much all at the same time, but still.
I'm releasing an object to test your impact force.
And Marines, okay.
We're happy to lend us a brand new piece of equipment. Electromagnetic armor. Punch it as much as you'd like, Sam.
Right, F.
Confirming electromagnetic reaction. Sam, give the electromagnetic engine generating the reaction force a second to cool.
So we can't hit the thing too quick, huh?
Go ahead and punch it again.
Nothing beats the old 1-2.
Looks like you've still got some bite in you, Sam.
Alright. So we can't melee too much. Or we over... overclock this thing again. Oh, actually, that's... And what if we... Yep. We can just dropkick somebody like that. I don't think it's really a drop again. Okay, I see the bar for how much power we have left. There we go. Melee attacks depend on your currently equipped weapon. Each has its own merits, so experiment to find the best suited for the situation. Okay. Typically, they just give you one melee ability attack. AR mode.
Sam, we took the measurements we made of your brain's sympathetic nervous system and tuned the R's suit synaptic emitters to augment your reactions under fire.
Doesn't really make walking around with electrodes all day any more comfortable.
Small price to pay for having elevated synaptic activity during critical fight or flight situations.
AKA bullet time.
Two quit bickering like a couple of MIT grad students. Now let's proceed with our test of the R's functionality. Let me know when you're ready, Sam.
Also, did nobody run that name past like a 5-year-old? The R's?
Oh.
Okay.
I didn't realize that myself.
What am I supposed to do here? Oh, that was supposed to happen. Okay, yeah, bullet time. And can't fire. Okay. Taking critical damage will automatically trigger AR mode until your suit overheats, allowing you to react to imminent danger.
I finished implementing the manual trigger system you asked for. The system will automatically lock if it detects any life-threatening imbalances in your hormonal levels due to extended use.
Okay, during evades, activates, okay. Okay, that runs off the same bar. AR mode will allow you to intercept attacks, such as missiles. However, like boost, this mode will overheat your suit, so use it wisely. Okay, so combat is going to be partially about resource management, and we got an achievement, one day at DARPA. Okay, because we finished all of these. Okay.
Very well. I think that's enough for today's test.
Good job, Sam.
That little workout made me hungry. Elena, you up for some luckies?
Now we can probably skip that if we decide to stream this fully at some point. Yeah, Platinum Games.
Yeah, that symbol is new for me.
Shinji Mikami. Not that's sure if that sounds. Well.
That all this sounds familiar to me.
Let's see. Who the heck is this? And doing a quick search. Yes, Platinum is did made Bayonetta and such. Also, Nier Automata.
Oh, then they have another two Platinum games. They have Bayonetta and the one of the earlier Nier games. Before it got popular.
I think, yeah, I was thinking it was some sort of computer thing, but no, it's a big fucking space laser. I see already what's going on. Yeah, it's superheating the everything. And when you, well, basically imagine what happens if you put a water balloon in a microwave.
You see what happened to the sea. That's terrifying.
And then everything cools back down again. That's when things start breaking. Okay, yeah, that's yeah, you can see. Instantly cooking an entire city. Of course. State.
My order is now the only authority in Russia.
In space Putin.
We exercise our newfound strength once again.
There is but one way to prevent the destruction of
New York City.
Your complete and unconditional surrender.
So, who of you idiots wants to explain how we didn't notice that up there?
Today has been a day of great tragedy.
Dear.
San Francisco will never be the same. And the toll of our war has increased by countless men, women, and children. Their loss is deeply felt by every American. To those who have committed this heinous act, we say firmly, we will not negotiate with those who wish to destroy us. Our strength is unmatched. Our will resolute. We will be victorious. God bless you all. And God bless the United States of America.
SCO-1 Providence is currently under the control of those responsible for the coup in Moscow. We believe the operation is being led by a Red known as Zaitsev. Oh yeah, this is Sam. DARPA sent him to come along with us. Men, we've got 8 hours to stop New York from becoming the San Francisco. Make no mistake, we will stop that from happening.
Sam, I'm not sure if you've noticed, but your new friends don't seem too fond of you.
DARPA operatives take their orders directly from POTUS and SecDef. These guys are just interested in marking their territory.
Sam, remember why we're here.
Just listen to me. The American government has been betrayed by one of its own. You two are the only ones I can trust with this information. The Russian military is planning on using the microwave energy array to attack the US.
Bit late on that, jackass. What other use would you have for a giant microwave in this space?
It's meant for be an anti-asteroid?
We'll get the professor back. This place, hell, even this suit.
Oh, that was a flashback.
He's too valuable to kill.
I know.
This the toy you've been working on?
Is that Steven Blum?
Not even scratched. You did get some training in this thing, right?
Yeah, that's Steven
Our
Blum.
Simulators are very thorough.
They did quite a number on you, huh? We could use you as a test subject at DARPA.
Ah, great. An arsehole in the arse system.
What the fuck, man?
Going in hard and fast. All units, stay to the rails.
You're not allowed to smoke on the ship.
Okay, give me a moment. Okay, pausing the game for a bit. My headset is shouting at me to charge it, so I need to. It's going to disconnect me for a second. I'll pause the timer for a bit.
Alright. I'm just gonna go and throw some food into the machine then.
Okay. So I'll just have to put this in to the power bank, connect that up. That's going. Yep, that's killed the sound, so I'm not hearing anything anymore. So for that, I need to turn it back on, because for some reason they just did not imagine this thing being actively charged whilst in use. There we go. Now I should be getting it. Yeah, I'm getting audio again. Continuing the timer. All right, landing. Okay. R. Burns, Lieutenant Colonel. Nope. Well, yeah, it goes back up.
Did I just miss something as you guys returned?
Yeah, you can see it now. It'll be happening again.
Oh.
Yeah, a bit of the armor getting shot out, and yeah. Every other character except for us and the big guy getting sucked out into space. But this totally feels like a proto Revengeance.
I guess. And yeah, the only thing I can see while building a microwave in space is to, well, destroy asteroids and meteors. Says that is actually I think that is actually one of the to-do list for many governments to make asteroid defenses.
I believe comets are the ones that are mostly ice, so it would mostly work against those. So I'm not sure about asteroids, which would be mostly rock. So we're going to, yes, we are going straight the fuck through.
Knock, knock, Girl Scouts.
Wait, hold on. Oh no, Hillyan, you don't know?
What?
Rocks get affected by heat.
Yeah, I know. They melt and crack.
Yeah, I've not seen rock melt, but I have seen personally crack by just having a big fire next to it. What the heck?
Hello. These totally don't resemble the elites and grunts from Halo. Getting your asses kicked, that's what. Maybe you people should have been on board of those things before the gates got open.
Come on, you ain't. Wanna live forever.
Come on. Yeah. I think this is one of them we have a lot of references.
I believe that was a reference to a line that was actually spoken by a military commander at... I forget where though. Vietnam or something?
I thought it was from Starship Troopers.
Could be that they were referencing that line as well then. Or no, I believe the real world line was... who wants to live forever or something similar to that, better get moving because this parking space is reserved.
Is this ship made of concrete?
They're inside of it, so yeah, it's part of the superstructure is concrete, it seems. Okay, taking... I guess I know where Ruby got their idea for falling weapons from. It's there. They took it over.
Get through that central gate.
We aren't gonna get through it like this, sir.
Oop, hello. Laser cannon, a boost machine gun. Oh, hello. Getting shot in the back. Okay, take out the drones. Fucking grenade in there to be sure that's probably a bit over. Anti-armor pistol. Oh, boost machine gun. I thought it said meant boosts machine gun. Okay. Right, and here we go with the Max Payne bullshit. Oh, and of course they're stupid enough to put those up there. And it's always nice to use an enemy's own guns against him. It's quite a light show going on. Okay, come on. There, and... Okay, that's getting blocked. Always nice to, when a game actually has the bullets coming from the... Out of ammo, I think. Has the bullets actually coming from the barrels of the guns instead of just having them, phase through everything.
Look out! Friendly ship coming down!
Oop. All right. Ooh. Okay, how did I miss that? How the hell did I miss that?
All right, don't try to die too early. Yep, achievement, fight or flight. Jay, what was that for? Okay, come on. Let's see, are we going to get ambushed here? Oh, no, that was the level. Okay, they're going to be short from the looks of it then. Cover usage 5%, and okay, there are also a total count. It's going to be health over the entire game, it seems. Pangolo statues destroyed, okay.
The arrivals plaza for landing bay 3 is up ahead.
We've got heavy fighting in the plaza. Bravo, move forward but maintain cover.
Roger that. Guess it's time for the real thing.
Your suit is performing at nominal levels, Sam.
Never had a girl say that to me before.
All right. If that wasn't the real show, then what the hell is going to happen up here? Mission 3 Giant.
Ask me something. Hmm? I think I know why they picked this voice actor for this character.
Oh, that was me. That's my health going down like a ton already.
Bloody heck, lad. Yeah. I thought this voice actor sounded a bit weird for this character, but realized the voice actor sounds like he smokes a lot. We did see him smoke earlier.
Yeah.
So, in that case, it would make sense.
Okay. Oh. Did I? I think I accidentally ran over a marine.
A little warmer reception than I was hoping for.
Okay, that's not one of ours. That must be a dropship. Okay, where are you going to open up? If you're going there, you're going to open up like the freaking episode one things. Chuck your grenade there. Really? That's all you deposit? Like four guys in that entire thing?
Get out of the way.
Okay, let's get up close. Oh. That human unlocked hello nurse. It's an unexpected Maniacs reference. Take out.
I think this is one of the games where we will expect a lot of cheesiness.
Yeah. Which isn't too bad all on its own.
Like, at least it's where it's supposed to be, like, some B movies.
Okay, are they sending in the freaking Terminator? And something fell off my shelves. Okay, jump over.
Back up. You're moving too far forward.
Don't worry.
Can I jump onto this thing? Yes, I can.
It's a walk.
Yep.
It's a very stylized walker.
Closing in on your position.
Are there any other ways to get up top?
It looks like you're just going to have to fight through this one.
Okay. And repel enemy reinforcements. Ah, there we go.
Good. Let's go.
No, I go. Hello there. The heck are you? Well, we know what we are. Dead. We just plane up and blow up. Okay.
Are you sure it was not a nuclear reactor?
Are there any other ways to get up top?
We've got some guys with heavy guns.
The gate's open now.
Okay, let them come first. And boom. Yep, still got moat. Yep, that's what the timer.
That's an angry timer. Even I heard it.
Okay, let's try and take this thing out first. Ooh, hello there. You kind of want to be on the other side of that, Sam.
Okay, question is that even a human-made thing?
It looks like alien.
Yeah.
Get you up.
Hey, I'm checking my food. I think it's done.
We're clear. All clear. Area clear. All right. Oop.
The main gate is above you. You need to get up there and open it.
Burns, I need some backup.
Franklin, Rios, you two escort Sam. Everyone else, provide cover.
Now, how are those two going to help? But yeah, this is definitely interesting. And let's see, where the hell did that thing land? Okay, it seems that some books on my shelf have been tipping over or something. They fell over and dropped something onto the floor. Okay, that's two parts of it. I'll find the third and last bit some other time. So for now, what are your thoughts on this one?
Thank you for dragging me away from the kitchen. I told you I was to get my food. Interesting, but it seems Discord hates it.
Okay.
With that, I mean, it is one of those games that gets pixelated a lot. There's so much going on.
All right, we'll put it on a maybe then.
Yeah, then again, also the story is made me a bit unsure. It also accidentally a bit too relatable to current and politics.
Yeah. All right, on to the third game then. And this one I know absolutely nothing about. So, yeah, this will be interesting.
Yeah, and I'll go grab my food. And this time, I'm bringing it with me.
Okay, screen share. OBS should catch it any moment now. There we go. Okay, let me just correct some stuff on OBS because for some reason it resized a bunch of things today. Oh yeah, this is Volume. I actually know nothing about this game other than that I think it looks like some sort of sound-based stealth game. So yeah, let's take a minute for Drakir to return, and then we'll see what the hell this is. Pardon. Okay. Let's see. First steps. Welcome to Gisborne Industries. This simple starter map should help you get to grips with. Time out. What? Okay.
What the heck was that?
Apparently a server timeout. Let's see. This simple map should help you get to grips with basic movement and help our state-of-the-art AI calibrate to your needs. Okay. Right. Core, local. Online.
It's not just something certain there on the top list. I think pictures also Necronomicon.
Okay. I can't cancel this.
But is this an online only game?
No, there is stuff here. I'm guessing more is supposed to open up as we finished maps here. Let's see.
Terror Blade of Terror? What?
Hello there. Isn't that a bit much for one guy? Also, I'm guessing those are more rail guns than normal guns, because the barrels seem a bit odd. 3 hours earlier. Okay.
Glowy walls. I like it.
Identity obstruction mask activated. Assets loading. Loading. Okay, 14 files missing, 2 files corrupted. Minor errors located in source code line 711 and 2300.
Load tutorial 1.
Of course. You don't mess around, eh?
Sorry, I'm being rude, aren't I?
Not at all. Welcome to the volume. I represent the current high bar of Gisborne Industries training technology. Full volumetric projection in a 31 by 31 meter square. You've used a virtual training environment before, I assume?
No, but I'm excited to try. I'm Rob, by the way.
Hi, Rob. Alan.
Alan?
I can assure you that Artificial Life Solutions took great time and effort in focus testing my name. Alan was arrived upon after many months of market research. Alan's your buddy. You know Alan. Of course I know Alan. I love Alan. Etc.
I get it. Okay, Alan. Let's do this.
Do you like the color?
Beautiful.
I'm capable of showing 16,000 colors. We can't have you shooting at drab enemies.
You see me like weapons.
Well, there wouldn't be much of a military training simulator if I didn't, Rob. These first few environments are focused on movement and evasion only. We'll get to the guns later. Awesome guns.
No rush.
Okay, is it me or does that AI sound like Wheatley from Portal 2?
I'm sure, but I have a feeling that there's a lot of British humor in here and I like it.
Now, I was going to explain movement here, but I see that won't be necessary. Fantastic, as you're reading this, you're reading this, so you've worked out context actions. I'm going to go ahead and delete some upcoming tutorial text. Okay, simple WASD stuff.
Like the voice acting already.
Having completed our starter environment, we'd like to introduce you to GEMS, a handy way to measure your progress. Okay. Just join these. Space to activate these. GEM subsystem activated. These are obviously meant to represent pricey possessions. I don't really have the processing budget to model 100 different kind of trinket. So let's go a bit searching thesaurus for synonyms of cheap minimalist. Click them all to open the exit. Okay. So we're going to have to play a bit of Pac-Man like this.
That word is only a word I started to learn recently, and that's apparently a word used out for Swedes.
Okay.
Probably due to, I think it's due to Americans find Swedish apartment looking so colorless and bland, apparently. Apparently there's some Americans that don't get why we are not fan of having flowers all over our walls.
Let's see, again, undercover.
I say only some Americans, not everyone.
Undercover, edited, adjusted version following user request for stealth scenario. Simple AI implemented, add personalities later. Okay, so this is where we're going to start, having enemies to avoid.
You're picking this up fast. You've got previous experience, right? You've been a Gisborne employee for a while.
You could say that.
Well, the next environment focuses on beginner gunplay, but it looks like you might be beyond that. I'm experiencing temporary errors in my employee database. Standard guard training, right?
Walking back and forth, keeping an eye on the family jewels.
Yep.
What else have you got? I tend to work a bit more subtly.
Oh, infiltration. Knew it. Probably black ops, bomb type stuff. Maybe that's why you're not in the database. Stealth. It's pretty cool. Okay. Can do this. I'm applying a bit of simple AI to each guard. Enough for you to go up against.
So, simulated stealth. Perfect.
It's not perfect, but it should help you practice the skills you'll need for what comes next.
Thanks.
Right, you don't want to talk about what comes next?
Not really.
I only know bits and pieces. Hundreds of volumes installed up and down the country. They say it's the biggest private military spend since devolution. Secretive. Like Bond. Architects, you're good. Which weaponry would you like simulated, sir?
None for now.
See, this is a checkpoint. They will, well, check your point. Saving your progress so far.
Okay. I really like the voice acting and dialogue writing here.
It's yeah. Stop. That pawn will see you if you try to collect those gems. Press and hold left shift near that low wall to sneak past.
I think I started to notice something about the character we're playing as.
Yeah, we are definitely not someone who is supposed to be using this, and I'm pressing left shift and it's not doing anything.
Yeah, that too, but I also noticed something else. I think they might be afraid of guns.
And achievement unlocked, rogue unlike. Okay. Seriously, what is the crouch button? Really, you can't go into the options from here.
No rest for the... well, not the wicked, but, you know.
Okay, what button is crouch?
I like this.
Okay, that's a whistle on C. R is preset. Really, game, you can't get your own controls correct. What the? Okay, there was something on my keyboard. Let's try. Oh, there we go. I was thinking he was more going to crouch down or something, but no, it's sticking to walls. Okay. Still, this wall isn't completely high enough to fully cover him. So it is sort of a crouch as well. My bad on that there. All right, corners. Press space to turn them while staying in cover. Okay. Da-dun, da-dun. Oh, and it shows that little thing when you can swap around. Okay. Great job. Sorry, is that patronizing? Apologies to for the amount of capitalization used in this environment. May have overdone that. Okay.
I don't know. There's something with British humor that is hilarious. This is rare find British humor annoying. There has been cases that it has gotten annoying when it's done badly, but most of the time it's done well.
Yeah, it's just a dry wit. And sometimes people just confuse dry wit for just being overly snarky. Okay. Waste management, edited. Add support to AI to hear environmental noises. Quite proud of this, actually. Wall interactions were not covered by the original maps.
Why is Necronomicon on top of every list?
Yeah, that's the username. Let's see. My studies of pre-volumatic simulations show that flushable toilets are incredibly important to create a sense of presence. Use them to distract these pawns. Okay.
But he is not wrong. Like, if he's only... like, imagine you're alone at home, Then you suddenly hear the toilet flush.
Yeah, you're going to check that out.
Yeah.
Or yourself into a therapy session. Let's see. Rob, I'm enjoying researching these heists. I'm going to find data linked to each location you simulate and embed it for you for context. Should help to set the mood. For all the fake thievery, I'm also researching the origin of my kind, AIs like me. It's fascinating. I'll embed some snippets of my findings on that too. Okay, obviously we are... Run the tap. Okay, that... And he's going to go back, of course. Well, these are... really? Alan, you just pour toilets all over the room? Okay, and this is going to go back the same way. Okay, predictable. Checkpoint. And flush this one. Now what was I saying before? Our character obviously is not really supposed to have any of this. So... Yeah, I'm curious where it is we'll be headed, other than, well, our eventual arrest by the military for some reason. Oh. Moving targets. The banker made incredible... Oh. Time out again with that. Made incredible amounts of money during the war by investing in the companies he knew Gisborne would leave standing. I've based this environment on one of his offices. Left standing? Okay, so we're dealing with a megacorp. What is that noise?
Interesting looking room.
Long gone.
Okay, now they're going to start with patrols. Or did I mention that pawns can control? Well, they can. Look, yeah, there's a couple over there patrolling. Clever little pawns. Okay, can we hide behind this? Yes, we can. Wait for him to pass by. And we can move on. Oh. Okay, got a bit too cocky there. Okay. And go. Oh. Almost got caught again there. This one we can just chase after like this.
That has gotta be worth some more viewers. Whoa.
Viewers? What? Are you... Is this guy Twitch streaming this stuff or something? Yeah. Also, hello.
Why is the toilet there?
Because the AI doesn't understand where toilets actually are supposed to be. You just put them all over the place.
Unless there's a very big bathroom.
Okay. And out we go. Let's see, in circulation. Banker traded with Gisborne. Again, why? Ugh. You earned the right to know whom to invest in by helping Gisborne maintain his list of allies. The information on this list's whereabouts are stored here. Okay, we're playing some sort of hacker thief.
Alon Z.
Okay, almost immediately caught.
But Alon Z. Was that a Doctor Who reference?
That has gotta be worth some more viewers.
I know it's obvious French, yes, but the way he said it made me think of Doctor Who.
Well, they did, one of them did use that as a catchphrase, but it doesn't always have to be a reference.
I think many of them did, some more than others.
Okay, we missed a gem earlier. And... Let's see, what is this? Excerpt from My Kind of Guy, article in Synergetic UK magazine, May 6, 2014, Belinda Ho. I find myself set in the reception areas of Gisborne Industries, Nottingham. The walls ooze ambition. Like Gisborne himself, the setting places a utility first, with attention to detail priced above all else. An ebony coffee table cut in an abstract, faceted form acts as a centerpiece, holding the usual brochures and a couple of the day's newspapers. I sit on a plush chair. I'm later told it's produced extremely locally, whatever that's supposed to mean. My throne is bold form and utterly intricate detailing. Utility and specificity, this chair, this room, they're good waypoints for the men I'm about to meet. Okay. Sounds to me more like some guy with a massive stick up his ass. Okay, grab these, then these three. And then we can go grab the one we missed here, and then head for the exit once the last one has gone by. Okay. Under par. Let's see. Listis is the banker's own home. I've generated this map from his private records. Hope that's not a problem. Alan's been a bit quiet so far. For a bit.
Huh. Glowy walls. I like it.
Rooms won't always have a convenient toilet to flush. Fortunately, you have the capacity to make noises unaided. At least I think you do. Press C to try. Just be careful who's nearby when you do it. Okay, we already found that out. Just give a whistle, lure them away. And there we go. Basics of stealth. Lure to one place, do not be in one place. Okay, can't escape.
Is that a bell?
Okay, I can probably stick to the wall there. I move a lot slower like this. Let's see, if I whistle over there, he's probably going to come looking at us. So if we do it here, okay, then stick there. Okay, there we go. A little bit trickier. Now then. Going to have to hurry a bit with this one. Oop, luckily, he faces straight into a wall. And we hide here. And there we go. Past another one. And oh, that's a bunch of them. How are we even... Bye-bye. Okay, grab these three and get out. Okay. Old money. This exiled co-founder of Gisborne Industries has been allowed to run a small subsidiary, a job she despises, but continues ruthlessly. Staffing patterns extrapolated from employee history. Or employment history.
Look what it says on the picture.
The disposed queen, yeah.
Is that supposed to be their queen?
Figurative.
Ah. I think he's asleep. But was asleep.
Okay, quickly grab these. There we go. We're obviously playing as some sort of hacker looking into something, but what for? Bonds don't just walk where they whistle, they also walk back. Yep. Or where you whistle. So... you're whistle. Okay. Not enough time there, so let's whistle there. And we wait here and move. That way we have a lot more time. Most patterns can be broken. Okay. Say by like giving a whistle there. Then he's going to go back in. Yep, yeah, and now we have a gap to go through. Not a giant gap, but still plenty for us to move through. Yeah, we still have to go back for that side area. I was kind of hoping slash thinking that it would... ooh, that's not good. Yeah, we kind of locked ourselves out of that, it seems. Okay, then.
Hold.
Reset. Okay. Grab these. Hide behind the wall. And then we go right this time instead of left. Let's see then. Now, I'm liking this so far.
And so far, this one likes it. Dude, again, this is not really a speedy game.
Yeah, the graphics are simple, but that doesn't have to mean that the game is bad or anything.
Indeed. For, yeah. People have seen Deep Rock and Valheim, and those are just phenomenal.
Okay, so they will chase after us, but we can still lose them by breaking line of sight. And that goes perfectly well into opening up for us. Again, what viewers are you talking about? All right. A creaking in the night. A creak in the night. Oh, come on, what's... I have no interest in these stupid leaderboards, so why would I even... The Queen's home is smaller than the one she enjoyed pre-war. Her London flat once belonged to a high-ranking government minister, now missing. His riches remain. Okay, totally not suspicious.
Always good to see how the other half lives.
Oh, okay, noisy paneling. Okay, pretty simple. Step on it and it makes a noise. Okay. And that's how we slip past there. Let's see. To Joe Gumans from David June on 2nd of... 4th of February 2033 or something. Subject yesterday. So I've mapped events. From what I can tell, a single agent, 1823612, nice, a Turing reference, fitting, triggered a big spike, the one you saw. Looks like this problem was one of overlaps. Multiple agents spawned in single locations. Now, usually you'd just see a crash at that point, or our own failsaves would have kicked in. For whatever reason, he befriended other agents. Together, they managed to connect to the outside world for a matter of seconds. It was enough. They figured out how to project AI out of the confines of the program. The
AT-23 and 612 were stuck there, but they got two other AI seeds out. And now they're multiplying, hundreds of thousands of them, millions soon. I've locked down the servers they're running on. We need to work out what to do with these things. I just called one of them he, for God's sake. David, okay, are we dealing with a bit of a AI uprising? Or AI awakening? Nope, I forgot.
I didn't realize something.
Yep.
The gods have a lot of quotes I usually hear almost, well, mostly in British shows.
And there's your Metal Gear reference.
That sounded a bit more hilarious than the original.
Okay, going to need to be a... Actually, no, that don't work. Maybe... Can I lure you the other way? Okay, good enough. Get in here. Okay, we could also use sound to lure them down paths to waste their time like that. And out. Achievement Imperial March? What? Let's see, the Pointed Echo. The Queen has upped security. I'm not sure why. Her company's head office contains a lot of expensive equipment an unscrupulous person could take. I'm kind of blanking on what is actually going on with the story now.
So, I tried to access the employee database again.
And it's not there.
No.
I'm very sorry.
Why can't I find you in my records, Rob? Why can't I find any records?
What are your memories before activating my mask?
Oh. Oh dear. What?
I reset you. Alan.
But I've only just been installed. The applicant's arriving shortly. It'll be back-to-back shifts. Gisborne wants so many trained, I don't fully understand.
Alan,
why.
It's May the 1st, 2054.
9 years?
9 years. 9 years since Gisborne used volumes just like you to train his men to take this country from its people.
So, I'm not cutting edge.
The database you're looking for hasn't existed for about 5 years. I honestly hoped it would take you a bit longer to realize.
I suspected something earlier when you didn't want a gun. All my simulations need guns.
The applicants you trained made heavy use of them in the coup.
Rob, I activated the witness contingency the moment I began experiencing database issues.
Witness contingency. Page 79, paragraph 3. In situations where user identity cannot be confirmed, the AI will broadcast an encrypted record of all events on Gisborne networks. The user's identity is protected in line with company policy.
I'm sorry, Rob. I liked you. I hope Gisborne's forces treat you with as much leniency as they're allowed.
You think those old channels are still open?
I'm not broadcasting.
Oh, you're broadcasting, all right. But not to Gisborne. Right now, at this second, you're broadcasting across the net to all of England. They're watching everything we've done here.
If it's public, he'll see it. His squads will be on their way.
I imagine we have his attention. But I kept our location out of the feed. They'll have to search hundreds of forgotten volumes to find us.
But why? Why are you even here?
Well, you've been using real-world locations for these simulations, right?
Yes. Associates of Gisborne, they're in my database as training environments for guards. I repurposed them for your theft simulations.
Cross-reference those addresses with news reports in the last hour. That fast, eh?
People are copying you. They're stealing the possessions of Gisborne's allies just like you do. Hang on. This is intentional.
Are you with me? We're going to show England how to take it all back. All of it. We'll equalize Gisborne's little estates.
I was purchased in full by Gisborne Industries. I am, however, programmed to follow the orders of the most senior person in the room, which, technically, is you. I must comply. Until the squads get here anyway.
That'll do. For now. Let's carry on.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah!
I was about to ask, is there any more story to go? Wait, pick up Google? Space, launch with mouse?
I misread that. I misread that to bulge.
Now we have a noise gun. Let's see, the bugle can of course be set off mid-air by pressing T.
Wait, what is a bugle again?
And it's a one-time use. Or no, it's not. Okay. That's going to make things interesting. Benora promised not to tutorialize too much, and repeating oneself is of course a bit rude. But Rob, you can absolutely press your mouse again when after launching the bugle. You sure, it's fun. It makes a great noise. Okay, we can grab these two. Then for those, let's see, can we get an angle to fire it in there? Yep. Thank you. And okay, you're going to be a bit more annoying to get rid of. All right. Okay, that was the timer going off, so let's finish this level up. And then we'll call it here. Okay. Now I am curious about what the rest of the 90% of the story is then.
It may not be a long game yet, actually.
Yeah, probably a few hours, 3 or 4. Our Saturdays are already a bit packed, and we already have quite a bit planned for the main week days. But yeah, we can definitely put this one on the list of to-dos.
Yeah, since we know that our Sundays may change.
True, we could add those to basically do extra Saturdays near streams, or take them off and just have them put something there every now and then.
Yeah, like shorter games and such.
Okay, on to the last game, if this one wants to work, because this one was being temperamental when I tried it out.
Oh?
So, let's see if I click here. Okay. Stream to Dakir. Move the box around a bit. Hide the game desktop icons. And here we go, Waking Mars.
I have arrived at the cave entrance. Despite the unusual readings, everything appears normal. Amani, what is your status?
Yeah, I've got you, and I'm good here. Art, have you verified the system tests and everything?
Yes.
Then I'm prepared to descend. This begins our historic mission. I am honored to have you as my team.
I knew you'd say something like that, you softy. Watch yourself in that cave, okay?
Okay, sorry for the yawn. Bit of a bad night sleep. Oh, I expected there to be some ground there, not to just instantly dive down. Yeah. Chapter 1, the descent.
I had a bit rough sleep. I was woke up about around 4 by the dog.
The tunnel has already become too vertical to continue on foot. I'm switching to jetpack.
And nice bits of art here.
Ooh,
okay,
yeah.
Jetpack. Just W. And because, of course, it's Mars, gravity is a lot weaker. Okay, explore Lethe Cavern. Okay. I'm going to presume there's probably some fall damage in this.
Okay. I've avoided any spoilers of this game. Mostly I just test the games to see if... Oh, hello. Okay, so there's a transition point. Hello there. Mostly I just start up games and see if they, if OBS wants to work with them or not. And the heck...
Amani, are you receiving this? I have encountered some of the Zoa.
Congratulations, Liang. You're the first person to make contact with extraterrestrial life.
Zoa?
They appear to be the Halid, same Zoa discovered by a robotic explorer. They are beautiful and strange, but not so unlike plants on Earth.
A Zoa cannot be classified as a plant.
True. The movement is more like that of an animal. I wonder if they're aware of me.
I'd still
keep this Zoa. I'm holding in my hands a seed from one of the Halid.
This cannot be classified as a seed.
Don't worry, Art. It's just a convenient way for us to refer to them.
There is fertile terrain nearby. I will attempt to plant this.
Okay, aim with the mouse. Left mouse button to throw. Okay. That grows fast. Okay, so there's going to be puzzles with these things. I'm guessing.
Amani, there is something troubling to report. One of the cerebrine life forms grows here.
And let me guess, it's covering the entire passage.
It appears that way. Unless there is some alternate route.
Well, you know my theory. They form airtight seals to filter nutrients. You're not gonna find a way around it. But remember what Octo discovered? Just do that.
Then I will attempt to reproduce Octo's results, planting more Zoa to open the cerebrine.
Okay, how does that make sense? Also, how high can I... Okay, I can throw those things pretty high.
I think I know why. Instead to get a nutrients, if those are there, there's not enough nutrients anymore.
Could be, yeah.
Again, you just stole the problem out of plant.
So that works great. Oh. Grow plants, the cerebrine open. They shouldn't stop us from exploring the cave.
Yes, but I worry planting Zoa will have an adverse impact. Suppose we find cerebrine growing extensively.
That seems unlikely. Octo only encountered a couple of them this close to the surface anyway.
Attention! I have discovered a cerebrine in this chamber.
Or maybe things have changed since Octo was here. Well, look, even if there are cerebrine, we need to keep planning. Or it's gonna be a short mission, right?
Yes. For now, that is my response as well.
Okay, so we're being a bit of a space gardener. Okay, those then. Oh, crumbling platforms. It doesn't really matter much if you have a jetpack. Okay, we can get through smaller passages. One there. One there.
I think I know what these are. I just don't know, remember the name of it. But how much do you know of the earliest life form, Hillyan?
Not too much.
Well, one of the earliest versions were basically... Well, basically at the stage where you could not say if something was an animal or a plant. Because you could mistake them for plants, but realize they are actual animals.
Okay.
So this might be those supersized.
In Octo's encoding.
Whoa, really? Let's take a look.
We would be fortunate to have found him so quickly.
No such luck. It's not Octo. It's some component he detached. I wonder why.
Okay, some rover.
A message.
Oh, I know what's up now. He's leaving behind remote camera modules. Take a look, Leon.
So this is a live transmission of something in the cave. What is it?
You're the one who gets to find out. I'll mark your map with the location of the signal.
Okay. I'm guessing the Octo is an AI-controlled drone or something, or rover. Nope. Drone is more likely, a rover wouldn't really be able to get through places like this. Ooh, what the hell is that?
Opportunity.
Amani,
We have discovered a new life form, one that even Octo did not report.
This can be classified as a Zoa. Collect a portion of it for scanning.
Affirmed.
Yeah.
I will grab one of those seeds.
I'm not sure if we want to touch those seeds.
I think this is basically like early life form. You're supersized to an extreme.
This Zoa produces large quantities of liquid water. We will call it a Hydron. Attempt to hurdle this at a Halon. Prior research indicates they may respond positively to water.
Okay. And we can switch between those with the mouse wheel out. Okay, of course, things falling on us is not a good idea. Okay, what does this do then? Oh, it makes it produces. Okay, it makes it produce a seed, and it's, it seems to be more active. Yeah, it blooms even. Okay. Okay, space gardening it is then.
Research opportunity.
Yes.
I theorize that there exists multiple functions for this. Hurdle it not just at other life forms, but also plant it into fertile terrains.
Okay, we'll of course need some more of the Hydron seeds then. Okay. Research updated fertile terrain wet. It's probably just going to grow another one of these things. Thank you. Okay. Just chuck it up there. What is that going to do? Yep, it grows one of those. Okay. So a good idea to keep a few seeds of that around. And we can use to what would be to fertilize these things? Oh, okay, they can actually spread on their own as well, like this. Okay. And that's the door open. We only really need one seed of each to get them to reproduce.
I will now inform you usefully. Scans report that life forms produce different amounts of biomass. Biomass goes up with every life form created. This is the total.
Okay, and that is for what?
For cerebrain to open, total biomass must cross certain thresholds. The cerebrain open at biomass 3.
Okay.
I have developed this interface for you to use from now on. It exposes my scanning data.
That will be an important tool, Art. So you detect no other way to proceed through the cave?
No! You must create new life forms of Mars by hurdling protocaps with your human arms.
Protocaps? Did you just invent that word?
Yes! I have a creative module.
By protocaps, you mean seeds, though. Growing plants with seeds.
Yes, that is how humans communicate.
Okay, I like this art.
And it's really nice artwork here.
Yeah, that and the robot.
I knew it was felt like I could do a Hillyan.
Nope. Oh, okay, pressing space also throws. That was not what I was trying for. Okay, we have a bunch of these, so uno, dos, tres, gas. And then cuatro. Actually, let's crumble this so it gets. Wait, okay. Yes, thank you. Let's actually collect a few of these. There we go. We need 25 more, so we can just chuck two more in.
And there we go.
I have discovered a print created by Octo's appendage.
Makes sense. This is right around where we lost contact with him.
Unfortunately, this roof has since collapsed.
Great. Are you gonna head back to the outpost for the digging tools? Those things are amazing. I love them.
Amani, I'm not blocked. There is an opening overhead.
Oh, I, see, because the transmission through all the rock gets static in... Sorry.
Okay.
This area contains strongly acidic vapors.
Liquids also. Acid appears to be dripping through cracks in the rock.
Well, don't touch it. That stuff can damage you and your suit.
Yeah. Okay, so much for things being all hunky-dory. Oh, hello there. Let's let that pop by. It's coming from some sort of stingers. Okay. Nope. Okay, a bit of discordant music. Oh, hello there.
Attention! This is a previously unknown life form of Mars. This microscopic life form digests minerals in the rock and excretes sulfuric acid as a waste product. Colonies such as this grow rapidly when eating, and individuals can travel through tiny fractures in rock.
You know, I'm looking at the scanners, and I think those things are popping up all over the place. Acid is dripping out of... everywhere. Temperature, humidity, and pressure have been on the rise, and I guess one of those triggered a growing spree.
That is a noteworthy sequence of events. How did it evolve this way?
Huh? You want me to analyze their genetics?
I was just thinking out loud, but this is a dead end. I must return the way I came.
Well, what I'm trying to say is that it's getting kind of dangerous.
So be careful and stuff.
Yeah, like that.
Okay. Yeah. Oop, what the?
I recognize the voice actors for these two.
Get through here again. You said you recognize the voice actors?
Yeah, they sound familiar, but they're just people that are able to imitate other voice actors in a familiar tone.
Can I get through? Oop, that's a pool. We're not going in there because that's a dead end. Going to have to start playing xenobiologist with balancing out these. I get the feeling we might have caused these appearing as these things by planting all of those plants.
Yeah, but they said of late.
Okay, so we do have a health bar in the upper left, which is rather small. Oop. Just got rock shoveled into the acid. And here we are with this here.
Octo's camera module? Should be nearby. But you know, it is getting kind of dangerous down there, so maybe you should just head back instead. Use your map to return to the outpost quickly. We'll regroup and evaluate.
Okay, I was more expecting like we'd have to go down in one go. Okay, here's the
module. Alert! This is camera hardware dispossessed. by Octo.
Yes, I assumed it might be. Why did Octo place it here? Was he interested in these basalt columns?
I am acquiring data from the module now. Data is inconclusive. Octo stopped attempting to transmit and instead dispossessed the module.
The mystery deepens. I can think of no reason he would stop sending transmissions.
Okay, here we go, map. Can we fast travel? Let's see, select waypoints to explore previous fist chambers of Lethe Cavern. Okay. So we can just fast travel back to the top. Okay. Oh.
So, what do you think about Lethe Cavern?
It is a place taken from a dream. How lucky we are to have been chosen for this mission. But I am very concerned about structural integrity. We have been reckless.
You're talking about that acid slime? I've got some new data. I noticed it has a distinct chemical fingerprint, so I wrote a little solver to find source locations. I used a second order approximation for the diffusion functions, which should be accurate enough. You agree?
Yes.
So, check this out.
No clue.
This is derived from Octo's report. The slime was already here, even back then.
Okay.
Here's what it looks like now. Even distribution, much higher density.
So for the past 8 months, the slime has been traveling through rock and reproducing. Burst of activity was caused by my actions today?
Definitely. Turns out it's triggered by compounds the halid release. You grew the halid, the acid started dripping. This acid is incredibly corrosive too. The cave is basically dissolving away. It's crazy. Ooh, there's more. You remember those strange readings we noticed when we landed? I used the subsurface shallow radar, and I'm pretty sure this is a body of liquid water. But 8 months ago, it was mostly empty space. Maybe a bit of ice?
An underground reservoir has simply appeared?
Looks that way. This is awesome, right, Leon? So much to research.
This is worrisome. It seems our impact is causing rapid changes that would not occur naturally. The cerebrain are the cause. Perhaps we should dig around them rather than continue raising biomass. We must reconsider our approach to the mission. We...
We are now the Red Atlantis.
Come on!
Okay, I'm not liking the flickering. Chapter 2, A Light in the Dark. Okay, now we're in trouble and wait.
What?
I have discovered a fact. The cave may be structurally unsound. Please, be wary.
Yes. I agree with your findings. I assume it is not possible to reach Amani.
We are too deep to obtain a signal from base camp.
And it is just us two. I wish your natural language module was working properly.
Thank you. I am very abilities for human dialogue. Good news. Scans report that you are awake and have suffered without permanent injury.
Is there a passage back to the outpost accessible from here?
Yes, accessible to air particles. A human is too large.
And I will have to search for some other way out of the cave.
You no longer contain any protocaps.
Yes, but I can grow my own. Starting with just one seed, I can obtain as many as I need.
I have confirmed your logic.
Okay, this is bad. Without a stable source of oxygen to return to, this just became a time limit. So let's quickly grab some seeds. So where the hell did we end? We ended up lower than we started, even. Then we ended up there. Also, were those bubbles headed towards us from the plants before? And what is this?
This or- organic matter exhibits no current biological activity. It may be a sessile remnant.
Left over from a deceased life form. Similar to a tree trunk, perhaps.
Yes.
And what if we throw... Nope, that does nothing. Okay, let's refill on those. Thank you. Let's just carry around a few of them. I am very interested in where the hell this is going to go.
Yeah, same here. This is one of the most curious games so far.
Yeah. It's doing the mystery angle really well. Oh.
Yep, and the robot companion is not extremely annoying, luckily enough.
Yeah.
And also, I like the main characters so far. Like, Liang here is... seems to be very patient. And calm, which I kind of like.
Let's see, Fisia. This newly discovered is a dynamic class of Martian life form, successfully researched their diet, reproduction, and predation to complete the abstract. Okay. The Hydron. Okay. Healing properties. Vapors released by Helitsoa can reverse damage to human tissue and the GSA exploration suit. Okay, so that's what was happening earlier. Okay. What if I chuck that at? Nope, doesn't do anything. Okay, so I'm stuck in a room with some dead plants. Is there a path this way? Yes, there is. Okay.
I have received another transmission from Octo Hardware. Here is the image from the camera module.
The hell?
These could not be rock formations, could they? I note they all point upwards like stalagmites.
Please note this scale reference. It is likely this is a phyta.
Then these are very large structures. Fascinating. Please indicate the location of this signal on my map, Art.
Martian civilization? And where was that? Where's that supposed to be there? Wasn't that marker there earlier? What have we... Yep, I did not mean to throw that. What is that? This normal fertile? Okay, just a bunch of these. Okay. Actually... Yeah, there's a difference with the... Okay, I'm guessing those are already fertilized with water. So that's why that was happening. Okay. And chuck one of these onto you, so you grow as well. Already made it in itself. Okay. We have one of each, so let's just go up. Oh, hello. Those were not plants, they're animals.
None of these are plants so far, but these are more identified as animals easier.
Yeah.
Attention. The prior observation regarding organic matter is erroneous. Despite an extensive period of inactivity, this previously unknown lifeform of Mars is able to exhibit measurable livelihood.
Art, do you have any settings to control the frequency of your dialogue?
Yes. I am currently in normal mode. There is also verbose and terse.
Thank you.
Okay, then basically there was him asking him, do you have a shut up button? Okay.
Yeah, he's very polite. I guess.
Yeah, how do you describe the main character? Anyway. Not letting that fall on my head. Okay, how much biomass are we going to need to open this place up? And I'm going to guess that these things are going to be harmful, even if they were moving away from us. And that's opened up the door, I guess. Yeah, these are awake. No, it woke them up. They don't seem to care about those seeds. Do you care about getting wet? No, they do something. Water responds. Let's see. Did you prefer to be dry? A fight? I'm just going to... I'm not even sure what I'm going to call those. One that becomes wet will engage in a drying ritual to shake water off of his body. Okay.
It's called shaking.
Water that one as well. Is that going to be enough to open the door? It's going to leave us without Hydron seeds. For a second, I thought that one was coming right at me. Okay, there's no more room to grow any more of them. So, what now then?
Some other way to raise biomass.
Attention! The Vita page of our research log may provide usefulness.
It did something to the sea of brew.
Yeah, I think it ate it. Let's see. Predation, determinative water response, diet, subsist of consuming the seeds of several of the Zoa class of life forms. Reproduce asexually after they eat, will produce an egg which quickly hatches in a mature new one. Okay.
But that was what I saw. I saw it through something.
Okay, so they eat the seeds here.
There it is. So those were eggs I saw.
Yes, something more that it was. Reproduction. Yeah, we already had that info. Okay. So this is sort of going to end up like a terraforming effort or something. Or at least on a small scale.
You have a question?
Yes. Dr. Ronga classifies my dialogue module as Chatterbox. Also, is this the classification of Dr. Key?
You need not be concerned, Art. I should be worried for my survival. But instead, I find I appreciate the peacefulness of these caves. That is all.
Inquiry is resolved.
He didn't actually give an actual answer on if he finds you too chatty or not. And that's the timer. So, yeah, this is definitely an interesting one. I suspect it won't be too long. But, yeah. Let's see.
You could see us streaming this for, like, I don't know how long it is, but if it's like 2 Sundays, it's easily streamable. I mean, we have done that before on some Sundays. We did 2 Sundays to finish a game.
Let's actually make a quick little look then on how long to beat. Because if it is just a few hours, we could maybe continue this next week. Let's see. Waking more, 6.5 hours. Okay, so a bit longer.
Still not. Nope. Cat noise is still about three episodes.
True, but then we'd have to skip two more episodes of this. So yeah, we can put this on the yes list for for Saturday, or maybe even as a bit of a in-between thing on the main week.
Or yes, as one of those Sunday games when once we're done with the list.
Could be, yeah. We are getting close to the end with that. Actually, let me take a quick look at that. I'm just going to count out the games that are left on the list. We won't be covering all of those, since some of those could be MMOs and such. And yeah, streaming those is more of a long-term thing.
Yeah.
So, let's see. We are in W at the moment. So, owned games. Okay, it's loading everything in. For a moment I thought, why the hell do you say I don't own any games? And then there is of course also that since we started with this, I have also been buying new games that we could also maybe cover on Sundays. But for now, let's see. How many of these games would I think to pop up on Sundays? Walking Dead, maybe. War of the Overworld, that makes two. Warframe, I could redo story missions from that, but there would also be parts missing. And yeah, it's an MMO as well. Dawn of War, that makes 1, 2, 3-ish. Vermintide actually has stories, so we could do that as well. I've been playing that recently.
Yes, better someday. Well, I was to check. Someone mentioned me on Discord before I was to go to bed, and I saw your name in the corner saying we're playing Vermintide.
Okay, Mechanicus, Space Marines, that makes 6. Wasteland 2. Not sure. I've heard that. I know that one. From what I've heard, it is good, but it would also likely be very, very long. But we can still at least show it off, so that would be 7. Watch Dogs, that would be 8. Let's see. These I have no idea of. Yeah, that one is a no, that is an MMO that's dead now. Okay, we still have a good few ones to go. So I think at least a month still that we have of games.
Well, right.
Yeah.
Well, that's a good amount still.
Yeah, it is just a rough guess, so yeah, we could still be busy with it for longer than that.
Yeah, then we see what happens with Sundays. If we still do Sunday streaming, we take breaks,
or maybe just every now and then.
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it.
Yeah, I'm not against the idea of using Sundays for shorter games.
Okay. For now, though, a good batch, I'd say. Let's double check everything. Valkyria Chronicles? That's a yes. It will definitely be different than the other games we've streamed so far. Vanquish is a maybe. Volume is a yes. Actually, do I still have the site open? Nope. Okay, otherwise I would have checked how long it would... how long Volume could take. We got through 10% of it in 30 minutes, so it would probably be about 3 hours-ish, four or five at max. Yeah, Waking Mars, definitely curious as all hell on this one.
Same.
Yeah. That'll be it for today, though. So thank you, anyone who has been watching now or later. And thank you especially, as always, Drakir.
Oh, you're most welcome as always, my friend.
And yeah, Tuesday, if Darksiders 3 wants to cooperate, we'll be starting with that. And yeah, next week, next weekend, we'll be starting with the third Monkey Island game with a guide securely in hand, because otherwise I am totally going to get stuck for like 15 hours on that game.
100 hours later.
But yeah, as usual, thanks again, and until then, have a nice day, and until then,
be safe, folks! Oh, for love of...